The American Thoracic Society and the Japanese Respiratory Society have published 4 additional clinical practice guidelines pertaining to the diagnosis of LAM and management of pneumothoraces in patients with LAM. LAM affects approximately 5 out of every 1 million women. In those with this rare lung disease, neoplastic smooth muscle-like cells arise from an unknown source, infiltrate the lung, and result in cystic change. Lung function declines at 2 to 4 times the normal rate and is often punctuated by repeated lung collapses. Most patients are breathless with daily activities and require supplemental oxygen within 10 years of the onset of symptoms. 4 additional clinical practice guidelines were issued by a 21-member multidisciplinary committee of clinicians and scientists. For patients with cystic changes in the lung characteristic of LAM on high-resolution computed tomography, or HRCT, but who have no other features of LAM, the committee suggests not using HRCT findings in isolation to make a clinical diagnosis. Sirolimus, which was recently approved by the FDA to treat LAM, is associated with potential adverse effects, so it is essential to have a firm diagnosis prior to prescribing its use. When a definitive diagnosis of LAM is necessary, the guidelines suggest a diagnostic approach that includes a transbronchial lung biopsy prior to a surgical lung biopsy. The definitive diagnosis by transbronchial lung biopsy can eliminate the need for a more invasive surgical lung biopsy. After their first pneumothorax, the guidelines suggest that patients with LAM be offered ipsilateral pleurodesis rather than waiting for a recurrent pneumothorax and intervening with a pleural symphysis procedure. Early pleurodesis decreases the risk of recurrent pneumothoraces. The guidelines suggest that previous unilateral or bilateral pleural procedures not be considered a contraindication to lung transplantation in patients with LAM. This recommendation is based on studies that have shown that the outcomes following lung transplantation in patients with prior pleurodesis were not substantially different than the patients who had not undergone prior pleurodesis. The purpose of these additional recommendations regarding diagnostic approach and pleural disease management is to help protect patients from inappropriate drug exposures, unnecessary surgical procedures, and recurrent pneumothoraces.